गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू टुडेज क्लास। लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद अ 10th लेसन, बैंक्स एंड सिंपल इंटरेस्ट। चिल्ड्रन, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन सॉल्व एग्जांपल्स दैट वर गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 71 एंड 72। ऑल्सो वी हैव डिराइव्ड द फॉर्मूला फॉर फाइंडिंग इंटरेस्ट अमाउंट। नाउ टुडे वी विल सी द प्रैक्टिस सेट 40। सो चिल्ड्रन, get ready with your textbook and notebook. Now page number 73, practice set 40 is given. Let us start with first question. Rihanna deposits 1500 rupees in the school fund at 9 PCPA for 2 years. What is the total amount she will get? Now children, as we are solving these examples using formula, we will first find what is given. Now Rihanna deposits 1500 rupees. So 1500 rupees is the principal, that is we will write it as P in short, in the school fund at 9 PCPA. So now what is 9 PCPA? It is the rate of interest. So we will write the second thing in given part is rate of interest is 9% per annum. Now for how much time has she deposited the money? It is for 2 years. So the time is 2 years. Now we know the formula for finding the total interest. It is P multiplied by R multiplied by T upon 100. Now in this formula, we will put the value of principal, rate and time and we will solve it. So now here the principal is 1500. So we will write here 1500. Now rate is 9% per annum. So we will write 9 in place of R and time is 2 years. So we will write here 2. Now here if you look at this step, here 2 zeros of 1500 will get cancelled with 2 zeros of 100. Now you will get 15 multiplied by 9 multiplied by 2 in the numerator. Now the denominator will become 1. Hence we will not write anything in the denominator. Now 15 into 9 into 2 is 270 rupees. Hence she will gain interest of rupees 270 in 2 years. Now we have to find the total amount, that is principal plus interest. Here principal is 1500 rupees and interest is 270 rupees. So add it, you will get 1770 rupees. Hence we will write the last answer. Rihanna will get total amount of 1770 rupees. Now next example. Jethalal took a housing loan of 2,50,000 rupees from a bank at 10 PCPA for 5 years. What is the yearly interest he must pay and the total amount he returns to the bank? Now children, here we have to find the total interest, also the total amount that he will pay to the bank. Now as he has taken the loan, he have to return the basic amount, that is principal along with interest, to the bank. So first we will write here the given part. Now what is given in this example? Principal. What is it? 2,50,000 rupees. Then the rate of interest is given 10 PCPA, that is 10% per annum. Now time is given 5 years. So we will write here T equal to 5 years. Now we know the formula for finding total interest. Here total interest is equal to P multiplied by R multiplied by T upon 100. Now what is principal? 2,50,000. Rate is 10 and time is 5. So now multiply it and divide it by 100. Now cancel 2 zeros of 100 with 2 zeros of 2,50,000. So now on multiplying the remaining number, you will get 1,25,000 rupees. Now this is the total interest that Jethalal has to pay to the bank. Now we have to find total amount. Total amount, it means principal plus interest. Here principal is 2,50,000 and interest is 1,25,000. So on adding, you will get 3,75,000 rupees. Hence, Jethalal will have to pay 1,25,000 rupees as an interest and 3,75,000 rupees as the total amount to the bank. Now, third example. Here, Shrikant deposited 85,000 rupees for 2.5 years at 7 PCPA in a savings bank account. What is the total interest he received at the end of the period? Now, children, again see what is given here. Here, principal is given 85,000 rupees. Time is 2.5 years. So, either you can write 2.5 as 2.5 or you can write in numerator denominator as 5 upon 2 years. Now, rate of interest is given. What is it? It is 7% per annum. Now, here these are the given part. Why a star is put on this example? Because in this example, the time is given in the form of mixed number. Whereas in the previous examples, we have seen the time is given in whole numbers. Now, here as it is given in the form of mixed number, so let us see what changes we will see in this example. Now, first we will write the formula. Total interest I is equal to P multiplied by R multiplied by T upon 100. Now, what is P? 85,000. What is R? 7. And time is 5. Divided by, time is 5 upon 2. So, we will write here this 2 in the denominator as it is in the denominator when we are converting it into improper fraction. Now, principal is 85,000. Rate is 7 and time is 5 upon 2. So, here this 2 will come in the denominator or you can say 2 will come in multiplication with 100. Now, again do the cancellation. Cancel these 2 zeros with the 2 zeros of 85,000. Now, here children, you will get 850 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 5 divided by 2. Now, on multiplying 850 with 7 and 5, and on dividing it by 2, you will get the answer 14,875 rupees. Hence, Shrikant will receive 14,875 rupees as an interest from the bank. Children, in this example, you don't have to find the amount because it is not asked there. So, you will find only total interest. So, you have to be very careful while solving the example. See what is given and what is to be find out.